I've been a police officer up in Jersey City for 13 years. I'm always jumping over cars, climbing over fences, jumping from roof to roof, chasing people. So this game to me should be easy.
I'm not telling the house guests that I'm a police officer because obviously a main component to our job is being able to tell who's lying to us.
I thought for a split second, should I tell them I'm a cop? Then I said, nah, you know what? If I tell them I'm a police officer, the first thing they're gonna be thinking is like, this guy's strategical, he's tactical, he's probably sharp on his toes, he's very observant, and they're gonna be right.
Here I am, back undercover in the Big Brother house.
So obviously I'm a threat to them, so they're gonna probably wanna try to blindside me right away.
When it's time to take LJ out, and then I'll go back to my alliance.
But right now they're desperate. When people are desperate, you do the thinking for them. So whatever I tell them, they gotta go with it. If they go against me, they're sealing their own fate. Here's the deal. I'm not gonna wait to get a punch thrown at me by LJ. He said he was willing to blindside Wu. It's true, I kinda set him up, but I don't care. I'm gonna try to pin all the troublemaking around camp on LJ, because that's what I have to do. LJ's a threat, so I gotta strike now, before he gets the idea of doing it to me. But first, I have a lot of work to do.
He's willing to burn you.
So, if you wanna, you wanna have another shock face?
Yeah, I mean, I'm down with that.
So this was gonna happen, man.
We're gonna start killing each other. Trust me, please, man. If you don't trust me, look for one of us.
Like, I have the idol, we're protected.
So this is better than an advantage in an immunity.
But what I really want to tell them is I'm protected, so don't even think about voting for me.
That's the real deal.
Oh my God.
It's still four girls, and I made a conscious effort to try to scare them a little bit. Just in case they're even thinking or plotting to vote against me, they know I have an idol.
I've never spent $500 and been so happy.
Time to change the game.
If we get rid of Spencer tonight, you and I are done.
Ray.
Why?
Because it's the girl guy ratio.
4-2. We gotta get rid of a girl tonight.
Oh, Jeffra.
It's time for me to be a hero and try to save you because I do not want to see you go before Jeffra. I'm willing to work with you to get rid of Jeffra, but this is the only way it's gonna happen. People are gonna hate me, man, because I'm not gonna tell Trish, I'm not gonna tell Cass.
So you're gonna tell
you,
me, Tosh, and Wu.
Not Tosh. You're gonna have to tell Tosh. So I would say I'm driving myself crazy, but I don't think it's me driving myself crazy. I think it's the game that's driving me crazy.
Yo, Wu, it's gonna be chaos tonight, my friend.
The jungle. I don't trust nobody here. They're against me, and I'm by myself. Me, myself, my idol, and I. Now there's four of us. But I was sitting by the fire, all by my lonesome, and Sarah comes over. And I said to myself, let me just give her something and see what happens. So I said, you know what, Sarah? I said, listen, I'm also a police officer. You were right when you told me.
Oh, it's a clip.
I told Sarah in one conversation that took place between Cliff and Lindsay, but that was a lie. That was a total lie. I just told her I heard stuff just so I could try to get her on my side. To me, it means nothing, you know? You could swear on your kids, on your family, on your dead grandmother. It doesn't matter to me. It's just words.
I don't trust nobody. I don't either at this point. You shouldn't.
No matter what you tell anybody, you can't trust them. I don't trust nobody here. Nobody here. None of them. And I'm sure they don't trust me. So Wu and Sarah's whispering something, and I said, you know what, let me go see what's going on. So I go up to them, and they look like this. Like a deer in headlights. As soon as I walked up, so I pulled Sarah to the side. Hey, Sarah, what's going on?
Who is in with us?
Are you sure?
I am positive.
A few days ago, I went to Sarah and I fed her some kind of lie, telling her that I heard Cliff and Lindsay talking about her. And I think from that moment on, I think I changed the game by having her on my side. So I believe now that she's part of my alliance. You tell me to trust them, I'm trusting them on your strength, on the strength of your word.
Uh-huh.
So if you tell me trust Wu, I'll trust Wu, but I don't trust them. As far as Sarah is concerned, Wu's on her side, which means he's also on my side. So I believe we're an alliance of four right now against Cliff and Lindsay. I'm here to lie, cheat, and steal. I'm here to drag people's dreams through the mud so I can fulfill mine. He has the heart, he has the drive, he has the ambition. You know, he has a strategic mind, so he's dangerous.
Can you trust me on this one?
I trust yeah. You, Donis, but this is what I think.
Hey, you guys do nice. I'm out. I'm looking for the idol.
Where's he going?
He said I'm out. I'm looking for the idol.
Oh, yeah! My peanut butter jar! Awesome!
I that they would all be chasing me.
I must be the luckiest boy in all of the land, maybe even the whole town. I won the Big Brother peanut butter jar.
I just want to walk around and look at the scenery and the landscape. Oh man, they're really not coming.
Two pieces of bamboo with other pieces of bamboo tied with flimsy twine.
Don't break my ladder, guys. Please.
No! I am so nervous.
No, don't be nervous.
He's surely joking.
It's kind of like, you know, playing a game with a kid where you just imagine it's all make-believe and then you realize at some point that for them it's not make-believe.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my kid.
Guys, you got to make sure you hold it real tight there.
Yeah! He's just a kid that is just begging to break something.
Hey, Will, have you ever broken any bones in life?
Yeah, a lot.
Okay.
It's not square.
I designed it.
Our second one.
How is this guy still alive? He does not give two cares.
Stop that, Yule. No, for real. If you guys want to use it, no problem.
Big boy.
I'm bored. I think I'm going to walk around.
I'm out.
Did you fall, dude?
I'm bored.
Okay. I've had to lie, you know, cheat, steal, be, you know, devious the whole time.
She had me swear on my badge, which that doesn't mean anything to me swearing on my badge. Because I'm here to lie, cheat, and steal. I'm here to drag people's dreams through the mud so I can fulfill mine.
And eventually, break their necks.
That's what I'm here for. Whatever I have to do, I'm gonna do. It's as simple as that. I'm just watching the sun as it's starting to set. I wanna hit them like maybe minutes before we have to go to tribal.
We get Sophie out blindside tonight?
Yeah.
I'll do it.
That's it?
Yeah, I'll do it.
Oh, wow.
Me, Jeremy, Nick, Michelle, and there are two.
Can you give me some more with you? Kim and Sarah are voting for Michelle. Everybody else, including me and Nick, was supposed to vote for you, okay?
If Brittany had won that veto, it was gonna go down. She was gonna take Danielle down, Ian was gonna take me down.
See, but I was thinking that Shane could win the next HOH and I'd be all right. But I'm thinking that's impossible.
I was completely by myself, so I had to try to work with Ian, Shane, and Brittany. But now, it turns out they've been lying to me for weeks.
So now I'm taking Nick away from their numbers, I'm taking myself away from their numbers, and I'm giving them to you.
No one would ever think we'd be working together.
But if I went to Jen and said, Jen, look, I know you and Danielle are tight. What do you think about me, you, Dan, and Danielle?
Me, you, Nick, Michelle, as four of us, I'll be looking for Sophie. Sophie goes home.
13th person voted out of Survivor Winners at War.
Because when I'm going to go grab Danielle and pull in the arcade and be like, that was an act. I'm trying to save us both.
Yeah.
And I think I just did. Because she won't say anything.
It means he's also on my side. So I believe we're an alliance of four right now against Cliff and Lindsay.
If I get Brittany out of this house, Ian will be by himself. Shane will be by himself. If me, Dan, Danielle, and Jen are working together, then it'll be us four and Joe. I've been worried about somebody that might take me to the final two. And now it seems like Dan might be that person.
You swear on your badge you won't turn your back on me.
Oh, I swear on everything I love. I won't turn my hat, my back on you, whatever.
Hey, Book.
Hey, Dan.
I swear to God, man. On this, on my wedding thing, on my wedding ring, on my chain from my dead grandfather. Everything I'm telling you is the complete truth.
Final two?
Yeah, final two, man. We gotta come with a name, though.
We'll figure one out.
Whatever. She had me swear on my badge, which that doesn't mean anything to me swearing on my badge.
I'm gonna tell you guys another thing, too. I am a police officer. I was only kidding about construction, all right? So, all right, but... And
that's clever.
No, I'm not.
Well, the beauty of having me in this house is that I'm the biggest liar in the house, maybe the biggest liar in California, and let's go on a limb here, possibly the biggest liar in America.
And he's quiet and he's sneaky, and that's more scarier than a person like me. You know, I'm in your face. But LG, on the other hand, he's been thinking about all you guys since day one, behind your backs, and you wouldn't even know about it. And that's what I have to do. I have to pin everybody against LJ.
That's how intelligent you are. You have no idea what you're saying right now. Talking to people and revealing secrets is a totally different animal.
Secret?
When I told you that, you weren't supposed to tell them. You get it? I'm sorry, I don't talk llama. I'm supposed to talk llama to you. You understand that better?
I never said ATS.
You think you can talk to anybody how you want with no repercussion? You're a fucking bully. You just talk to people. You talk down to people.
I don't care. You like to keep people
when they're down.
If you have something to say, since people are lying, then maybe you should come and ask me first instead of confiding in other people.
Let's have a big argument.
Listen, I know what I said, dude, but you don't know what you heard.
Tony, everything that comes out of your mouth is a lie.
I didn't talk about you. I've never said anything about you.
So you can make all the reactions that you want, but guess what? The only person who's shaking their head and not looking at me is you.
Make sure you play your idol.
Listen, don't tell me how to play. You write my name down, you're going home.
Now, I told you, Dominique, people could choose me to use me as an asset and go far in this game, or they could choose to use me as an enemy. And it has been made clear that you are choosing to use me as an enemy.
Spence, you heard what I told her?
Yes, that you're the special idol.
And you'll go home. Put my name down.
So show it to us.
I don't have to. Put my name down and you'll see it.
When somebody tries to call me a snake in front of the people that I built my reputation on, that is when I get upset and defensive. And I will be defensive.
Say that Tony's response to Jeremy, I think, is completely false.
Don't say I didn't care. Don't say about caring, all right? Because me and him shared a lot of intimate moments together and that was real. As far as gameplay, I did work with you as far as I could, but I couldn't go any further with you because I was scared of you.